great for baseball is played clear and warm and nice and dry. What a day to sing and celebrate, ever see a bluer sky.
And some men in baseball uniforms, but Bill's heroes strong and tall. I should know, for Casey's one of them, he's the finest man of all.
I can see him standing at the plate, shoulders broad and arms like that. When he swings, the crowd's hysterical. He's a demon up at bat.
You should see him dressed up for a date. Makes my heart just melt inside. Always acts the perfect gentleman. I just simply glow with pride.
Weather's great for baseball, isn't it? Makes me almost want to play like I did some 30 years ago. I was something in my day. What a day, what a perfect day.
Looking at it through my eyes.
What a day, what a perfect day. Looking at it old and wise. Oh, what a day, what a perfect day. For the championship of the state. Quite a crowd came down from Centerville. Lions, Elks, and Rotary. All the big shots, even congressmen, straight from Washington, D.C.
Casey wants me near the batter's box, says he'd like to catch my eye just before he starts to wallop one. Isn't he the sweetest guy?
Time's a wasting, I've got work to do. Whitewash all the infield lines. Aren't you behind your schedule, hanging up those cake sale signs?
Gosh, oh golly, I'm a mile ahead, standing like a rusty gate. Casey said he'd call at 1 o'clock. Boy, I better not be late.
What a day, what a perfect day. Looking at it old and gray. What a day, what a perfect day.
Looking at it young and gay.
Oh, what a day, what a perfect day for the championship of the state. Wait and see. Things are quieting,
things are quieting down.
He carved a bit of wood and shaped a leather ball, scattering bases here and there as he stood bellowing a call. I want some volunteers, but everyone a man with courage and with fortitude to try this original
plan. Try this original plan.
And since that fateful day, and since that epic game, millions of mighty men have played, and the world hasn't been the same. Now Abner in his grave, a difficult man to please, would smile at such a team as this, such glorious men as these.
Such
I pitch a real fast ball, also a bender, a snake ball, and well, naturally, a spitter. I'm considered big league timber.
Pitcher Andy Jones, and also the catcher.
I'd like to take this opportunity to remind everybody that between games, I'm available for carpenter work, lawn mower sharpening, and other handiwork. You might also like to know I'm batting a 374. Thank you.
Pitcher Andy Jones, medals to the catcher, Burroughs played first.
Otis Burroughs, how do you do? I guess you know, my pop owns a local barbershop, which is a profession, well, I'm not so keen about. Besides playing ball, I'm the volunteer fire chief, second year.
Pitcher Andy Jones, and also the catcher, the Rose playing first, Tony Brody second base.
I'm so happy to play for Motel second base. Motel is a good place. I like it. It is not too early to buy coal for this winter. If so, remember, Perrone Ice and Coal Company, Main Street. Thank you.
Mr. Andy Jones, and also the catcher, the Rose playing first, Tony Brody second base, and we're playing at third.
Hiya, I'm Blake, the man with the double life. By day, baseball. By night, there's Bobo Blake and his Mudville Melodeons. Bet you want to know what I do with my spare time. Well, I ain't telling!
Pitcher Andy Jones, red hole to the catcher, or no playing first, Tony Brody second base, Elmer Blake at third, Scooter Cooney shortstop.
At the Tuttle place right now. Me and old man Tuttle just laid 30, 40 acres alfalfa. He don't like to let me off the play much, but he do come and watch. And if I ain't batting, man, he can be me.
It's your Andy Jones, and also the catcher, but Rose playing first, Tony Brody second base, and we're playing at third, Scooter Cody shortstop, the Rose playing last.
Slugging the umpire, been fined seven. My hitting's real good this year. I'm batting a 362.
Pitcher Andy Jones, red hole to the catcher, the Rose playing first, Tony Brody second base, and we're playing at third, Scooter Cooney shortstop, Rob Ross playing left, Barry Ritzy second field.
Dependable Benny, that's my name, and I'm proud of it. I like the guys on the team, and I think they like me. Great bunch. Especially, well, you're gonna meet them now.
Pitcher Andy Jones, spread all to the catcher.
Burrow's playing first, not even on his second base.
Her Blake at third,
Scooter Cooney shortstop.
Rob Haas in left,
Ben Urbanski center field.
Right field, right field, right field, right field.
He's a terror, he's a knight, he's a bird, oh, a wonder, terror, slugger.
extremely rocky for the Mudville Nine that day. The score stood 2-4, but with an inning left to play. So when Cooney died at second, and Burroughs did the same, a pall-like silence fell upon the patrons of the game.
We can't.
Flynn let drive a single to the wonderment of all. And the much despised Blake tore the cover off the ball. And when the dust had lifted and they saw what had occurred, there was Blake, safe at second, and Flynn a-hugging third. Then from that gladdened multitude went up a joyous yell. It rumbled in the mountaintops, it rattled in the dell. It struck upon the hillside and rebounded on the flat. For Casey, mighty Casey, was advancing to the bat.
Give him the game on the platter. You're dying to finish our heaviest batter. You're lying and cheating, and that's what's the matter. You. You're crooked as a corkscrew. That's what's the matter.
My name is Buttonheiser.
Buttonheiser?
You will never, never, never find any umpire who is fairer, more accurate, more honest, or wiser. I'm the umpire of this game, by virtue of the fact that my judgment is beyond reproach, my vision quite exact. As the umpire of this game, I find this no excuse for profanity, vulgarity, and hoodlum like abuse. I'm the umpire of this game, and always will object abusive tongues and gutter talk, in short, I won respect. As the umpire of this game, my verdict is complete. For a strike of balls, of all the twain shall never be.
He's the umpire of this game, and guilty on the glass. For he does a good, he does a big, and give him respect.
I saw the
pitch. I made the call. I called the strike. You think it's a ball? Well, that's the herd. I call it as I see. If you feel it isn't true, exactly what, precisely what you are going to do. I call him as I see him, and that's it, and that's the word, that's all. Labor.
To the pitcher, and once more the spheroid flew. But Casey still ignored it, and the umpire said,
"Strike two!"
Fraud!
Fraud, cried the maddened thousands, and the echo answered, Casey in the audience was awed. They saw his face grow stern and cold. They saw his muscles strain. And they knew that Casey wouldn't let the ball go by again. The pitcher moves with caution. His eyes then sweep the field. The catcher's hand then gives a sign, the pack between them sealed. The pitcher knows his signals. He's been taught by plotting brains. A high inside ball twill be, for a single strike remains.
Ah!
mighty Casey has struck out. Mighty Casey has struck out, as he knew all along he would. But don't go. Stay for just a bit. It's over in your mind, it's done. But what's in Casey's mind? How does a man survive such a thing? How does he live with himself? Who helps him? What helps him? Let's watch and see.